not a black magic woman.
Dean Winchester's clock is ticking. He's been battling vampires, werewolves and evil spirits. And in order to save his brother Sam's life, he's even sold his soul to a demon. In exchange, Dean has just a year left to live before he's engulfed by the flaming fires of hell.
Dude, what's going on with you?
What?
I mean, since when are you Bing Crosby all of a sudden? Why do you want to do Christmas so bad?
Why are you so against it? I mean, were your childhood memories that traumatic?
No, that has nothing to do with it.
Then what?
I don't get it. You haven't talked about Christmas in years.
Well, yeah. This is my last year.
With production of 10's hit series Supernatural at a standstill, the US writers' strike has been a blessing in disguise for Dean's alter ego Jensen Ackles. It's enabled the actor to squeeze in a trip down under, where he's been taking in the sights, smells and gastronomic delights of Sydney, and he joins us from there now. Good morning, Jensen.
Morning, Jensen.
Morning, David and Kim. How are you?
Good,
very
thank you.
Very well.
And yourself, how are you enjoying your time in Australia?
Having a great time, actually. This is first time to Sydney, second time to Australia, so I'm having a good time.
Tell me, on these press junkets, as they're called, do you absolutely work yourself silly with back-to-back interviews, or do you get to go out and have some fun and have a late night?
No, it's not too bad. They like to pad us with some vacation time. So, you know, I've been here for about 4 or 5 days, and then you got to get about 2 days of really intense, you know, work. But it's worth it. You know, you get to see a beautiful country, meet some new people, and talk about something that you love to do.
It is intense work, isn't it? You basically sit in a room and you get a whole lot of the international press come in and ask you a whole lot of questions. Do you find the same questions in and out day after day?
There's a lot of repetitive going on, yeah. But you know, there's a lot of new questions too. Sometimes you get something that you haven't heard before, and it kind of makes you think. You know, yeah. You don't want to fall into that whole that thing about just giving default answers every time you hear the same question.
Yeah,
so.
Sure. Yeah. I'm intrigued. You were born and raised in Texas, the great state of Texas. You know, it's amazing, Joy. To what extent is Texas embedded in you?
Well, when I first moved to California, I was 18 years old, and the first thing I did was hang a giant Texas flag in my window. So that should go to the show that it's pretty deep. My entire family still lives back there, and I go back quite a bit.
But did you
and Jessica Simpson?
Yeah, that's right.
did you have to move from Texas in order to pursue your career? Is it impossible to pursue an acting career from Texas, do you reckon?
It's not impossible, and the reason I know that is because my father is an actor and he lives in Dallas, and he's been doing it for you know, 30 years. So, but I think that if you really want to, you know, that he's kind of a big fish in a little pond there. So there's not a whole lot that comes through there, but whatever does come, he's usually a part of it.
Right.
If you want to go out to sea and find you know, the big projects and stuff, you got to go out to Los Angeles.
Well, yeah, but you're not even in Los Angeles. You're in Canada, as I understand. That's where Supernatural shot.
Yeah, that's another funny thing is you go out to Los Angeles to get a job and then all of a sudden you get one and out you go. So I'm up in Vancouver most of the year, about 9 months out of the year filming the series, but based in L.A. still, have a house there, so I go back there whenever I'm not working.
I was reading about your character, Dean, and it says that he is sexy, sharp, witty and badass. So how come you got the job?
I'm wondering that myself, actually. That's news to me.
Is it one of those roles that just comes along and you say, yeah, I've got to do this?
This one was, actually. I read the script and I originally was supposed to read for Sam, played by Jared Padalecki, you know, the brother to Dean. And I read the script and just fell in love with this Dean character because he was crazy, he was nutty, he was, you know, comedy and all kind of rolled up into one. And I was like, that's going to be fun to play.
Look, we're about halfway through Series 3, as I understand it, and I've got to tell you, we've been inundated with emails and calls to the switchboard here wondering if we were going to be speaking to you. You know, and I hate to sort of destroy everyone's illusions, but there are going to be two gorgeous new girls coming into this series at some stage to take up permanent residency on the show as your love interest, so I understand.
Well, it's not quite the love interest, and I know that a lot of people thought that, and the kind of flags were raised, and the fans went up in arms. But there are two girls coming onto the show, two new characters that are introduced in season three, and as opposed to being more of a love interest, they're going to pose quite a bit of problems for the two guys, which I think is a much more interesting dynamic.
How does that change the dynamic though, Jensen? When you've been doing a program for a couple of series, you're well entrenched in there. You understand each of the characters' roles, you have a relationship with each other, and then they introduce two other people. How does that change the dynamic?
Well, the interesting thing about this series is every week we're in a new, supposedly in a new town, so it's a whole onslaught of new characters that we're dealing with on a weekly basis. Granted, Jared and I have the relationship that we've been able to build over the past 2.5 years. So we actually welcome the fact of having a character that we can have a reoccurring relationship, something to build on, something to, make something of, as opposed to somebody who comes on, you work with them for a week, and then out they go. So it's actually kind of welcome for us.
Yeah. Listen, what's the go with your car? I mean, it's
what's
written off,
with
and then
the car?
And it comes back, and what is it? It's got a fan base of its own.
It does. I think they've touted it the Metallica car. But it's kind of a character unto its own. It's a 67 Chevy Impala, and it's just a good old Americana muscle car.
Yeah.
And
plenty of room for a body in the boot.
Plenty of room for a body in the boot. That's right.
And a few bodies in the back seat, I reckon.
This is true.
Hey, Jensen, you've been able to get the time off to come out to Australia and do this press junket because of the writers' strike.
Yes.
What do you know of the writer's strike? We're told that it looks like a deal is about to be made. What do you know, and does that mean you'll be going straight back to work?
From what I understand, it looks like everything's kind of coming to an end, which is great for us because it lasted a little bit longer than anybody was anticipating,
sure.
I think. We have been on kind of a forced hiatus now for about 2 months. And as soon as the official word is given, the writers are back in the office. They're gonna pump out a script, and I think we'll be back to production probably a few weeks after that.
Realistically, how long does that take, though? Because I'd imagine there's going to still be a bit of lag while they write those scripts.
Correct. Yeah, they've got to write the script. They got to get that done, which it shouldn't take them long. I think they were about done. They were almost done with the script before the strike hit. So there should be one almost done. Once that's complete, then we'll go into pre-production. So they're going to have to go scout locations, they're going to have to build back up the sets, and they're going to have to get their crew back together. So that's going to take a few weeks.
It certainly highlights the importance, the need for the writers, doesn't it, this strike?
Well, absolutely. I mean, it's these guilds, that's why they have them in place, right? They're so important. We've got the Directors Guild, we've got the Writers Guild, we've got the Screen Actors Guild. I mean, and all of these play a very integral part into what happens in the entertainment industry.
Yeah, look, it's lovely to talk to you. Thank you so much for sparing some time, and I hope you get
Thank
to enjoy
you.
A few more wonderful restaurants in Sydney.
Me too.
Thanks, Jensen. All the best.
Thanks,
Bye.
Guys.